come out a little bit tonight. I'll talk a little bit on the front of this one, so you can know just exactly how new this piece is. I was at the International Tuba Euphonium Conference playing this last summer, and I was fortunate enough to be in the audience when Dave Zirkel from the University of Michigan gave the premiere of this piece by Amanda Harberg that you're about to hear. And as I've been going to Tuba Euphonium conferences for 25-ish years now, and it's like you hear a lot of new music at these things. It's like, oh yeah, that's nice. Oh, it's new. But within about 20 bars of this tune, I'm thinking, yep, there's a new staple in our repertoire. I mean, it's a really great piece of music. So it's not too often where, you know, you get the opportunity to be at the premiere or something that's like, whoa, that's gonna be a winner. So here we are in three movements, Amanda Harberg's Sonata for Tuba and Piano.
Thank you. Thank you.
Art gallery only has two pictures of them. So usually, you don't like on stage if you see the white glow of light on people's face from their phones, but I didn't want to, the way pictures and stuff work in here is you put a screen down and it kind of, when your tuba bell's going up, it's just a mess. So I figured I'd just tell you, get on your phone and Google Grant Wood Young Corn and Grant Wood Stone City Island, because I guarantee you know a picture of Grant Wood, and it's the third movement of this that we're not doing it. He's the dude that did American Gothic. You know, that I live, when I'm with my pigs and my overalls on my pitchfork, because they're like this. I'm living American Gothic, but I didn't do this one on this recital. So we've got two of them, Young Corn and Stone City, Iowa. And it's really, if you're looking at the pictures, this music is really, really evocative of what those paintings look like. It's pretty cool. So. Thank you. Another reason I didn't play the fourth movement was because it was George Washington, I can't remember the title of the movement, but it's George Washington cutting down the cherry tree, and in it, Barbara York uses a whole bunch of ruffles and flourishes, and I had enough of that in a previous life, so I was like, I don't want to hear that stuff. So the next piece, this one's a fun one. It's like, and it's very, this piece is really meaningful to me in that a long time ago, my teacher, Scott Watson, took us to hear this group called Summit Brass in the late 80s and throughout the 90s. Summit Brass was like the first touring orchestral brass section that played brass ensemble music that had been around since that we're getting in the weeds here for you non-brass players. But there was a famous recording in the late 60s made by the orchestra sections of Cleveland, Chicago, and Philadelphia. And that's just like one of the holy grails of that style of ensemble. And then, you know, 30 years later, Summit Brass comes and Scott takes the whole studio and we go hear this. And the two tuba players are Gene Picorni, who is still the principal player in the Chicago Symphony, and Dan Parentoni, who is widely known as Mr. P. And they're both fantastic players. And they did the brass ensemble version of this. And it was just like, I was absolutely blown away by this piece. So I was looking for some new things to play and I came across this and I thought, oh yeah, Analyses, that's cool. And then I looked and I saw that it was for tuba, narrator, and piano. It's like, when did that happen? So this is the first time that I've gotten to play this because I didn't know it existed. So, but it's for narrator because this is the poetry of Ogden Nash set to really quirky music because the poetry is really quirky. And when you think of really quirky, you think of Gabriel DiMartino is going to be the guy who kind of, yeah, I kid because I can and because I love. But, and because I'm wearing the chicken socks that Gabe gave me. So Gabe's going to come out and narrate, and after the show's over, he's got some books of more Ogden Nash poetry, some really old books, and you can look at it. They're all just quirky stuff. He's going to leave them on the front of the stage. So check that out. But first, check this out with our narrator, Gabriel DiMartino.
Hyena is the kind of beast I'd not sit down with to a feast. He is appetite, undiscriminating, and mindless laughter. Hyena.
Thank you.
So we've come to the end of our brief recital, and I haven't said anything yet because this is the first time that I've gotten to collaborate with our new faculty piano player, Narae Lee, and let me tell you, isn't she something? All those perfect notes coming out makes up for some of the clams that's coming out, so it's kind of cool. This next piece I came across, and I thought that I was really taken by just the title. I hadn't heard it. It's called Rhythming. What even is that? I started Googling it, and Thelonious Monk had some rhythming that was that he did some. He had an album title, a couple records that he used the word rhythming, and I thought that's kind of weird. And then Jerry Grant is the composer. I didn't know much about Jerry Grant either. I have a doctorate, I did earn it, but this stuff wasn't on it. I had to learn about things like Debussy and dead composers, and it's like whatever. But I didn't know this guy, so it's like I looked him up, and being a hardcore Gen X dude here, child of the 80s, Jerry Grant wrote a whole bunch of stuff for the A-Team, for Hunter, for Hardcastle and McCormick. I've just lost my entire studio because they've never even seen these things. But he wrote all this 80s stuff, and he worked in Detroit in Motown scoring things for the record companies there. So he had a really diverse background. So it was really, really interesting. And then I got the music. So I hadn't heard it, I hadn't seen it, had a title, had an interesting composer, and then I got the music and took a look at it. And it looks like somebody like poured music in a blender, pressed go, and then poured it out, because it's like it's organized. But it's time shifted. So for the music students in here, it's like you're in 4-4, but you're really in 8-8 that's divided into 12-16 plus 2-8 at the end of the bar. So you're looking at stuff, and what looks like a downbeat doesn't sound like a downbeat. So it's extraordinarily confusing. So I hope I bring that out to you in this. No, I don't. So again, thank you for coming. Thank you for listening to us collaborate. And thank you to Gabriel for bringing the weird stuff. And don't forget to check out the books of Ogden Nash poetry. It's some really quirky stuff. So this is Jerry Grant's Rhythming with Air and Hammers. This isn't part of the tune. It's not performance art. It's just emptying space. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.